The situation in Milwaukee this week, I think, bears taking a look at. This Josh Hader is a guy who, when he was 17-year-old, the tweets, they unearthed them. They weren't very flattering. The Milwaukee crowd gives him a standing ovation in response to all this stuff coming out. And we've seen this before. I mean, Ray Lewis was a serious situation. Do we just dismiss this, or as sports fans, how do we process
Your arms around it, you know, and you get your head around it as well? I think you're going to find more and more of that moving forward. You know, as a parent, you try and teach your children, or as a coach, you try and teach your players, social media can never go away. And I think we're running into a new era of finding out really what people's character are like, really what they're about, how they think, how they act, how their family life is. And there's no way to avoid it because kids don't get it nowadays. So we're going to see more and more of this. We're seeing a lot of it now. I heard that in Milwaukee, only maybe one out of every four people stood. I think it's just a reflection of population and thoughts and theory. I don't think the entire stadium stood for him.
Yeah, there's a Milwaukee columnist that I read this week that just an African-American columnist who dismissed Milwaukee said, you know, it's a racist city. They're backwards, a racist city. It isn't that simple, though, is it?
No, it's not. And I think what happens sometimes with fans, everybody wants their point heard. They want their reaction felt. Okay, so the realistic way, if you want to support Hader, you want to say, okay, I think is no reaction. Is if you don't go after him, he's not booing him, you appreciate this part of it, that he did, at least publicly, say all the right things to make up for things that he did in his past. But the standing ovation, to me, is a notch farther. But I think it's inherent in people now. Again, social media and every other way, they want their voice heard. So instead of just quietly sitting there, like in any other game, if he strikes a guy out, you clap for him. If he gives up a hit, you're not happy. They give him a standing ovation because they have to do something to show, quote, support. And I think that part is over the top. You don't have to boo the guy. You understand that there's something in the middle between this 17-year-old and what he sort of got caught, I guess, doing in the past. Standing ovation's a bit much.
Well, like, what are you giving an ovation to is the question. Right, are you giving an ovation to the guy? Okay, that's all well and good, but it's before he did anything. Like, and it's not even like, to be fair, listen, I feel for the guy, right? We've all done stupid things as kids. This is a whole new world that we're living in right now. I don't agree with what he tweeted, obviously, but whatever. But like, it's not even like he came out, pointed out what he did and said, I'm sorry.
Yes.
He was caught.
That's how
it always is. Yeah.
But, and that's fine. Like, okay, fine, whatever. And hey, like, if this kid had come out and said, I was this horrible person, or I said these things when I was a kid, I now see the error in my ways, and I wish all of you could see this, that's standing ovation worthy. He got caught with a bad tweet while on the mound at the All-Star game, right? So
a 10-year-old bad tweet.
No, listen, I will give him slack on that. They're like, I've done horrible things as a child, right, that I didn't understand at the time, and I give him that grace. I guess what it comes down to is that tribalism, right? Like, if you don't like him because of what he did, and I like him, that means I must be okay also with what he did. And that's not true. Sure. And that's what we're going to see with LeSean McCoy.
Full measure of credit. Unfinished business. 2 weeks ago, you brought up what you thought was a moral dilemma for you, father of a daughter, saying, you know, I don't know how to deal with this.
Yes.
McCoy.
Yeah, and I'm still at that right now, right? Like, it's all up in the air. And there are people now, Mike, you see it on Twitter, who have decided he's not guilty because there have been no charges filed or he has nothing to do with it. We had a guy tweet our show the other day saying he's innocent. I know he's innocent. Why? What has he done to give you the benefit of the doubt? I'm not saying he's guilty, but why would you put that kind of support and faith in a human being that you don't know because he wears a jersey that you enjoy?
But they will do it, right?
Oh,
if this all happens, he'll get a standing ovation of the first home game plays.
Isn't the word fan a form of fanatic?
It is, but normally that's based on activity on the field, less than it is showing. I guess there's no way to show any nuance, because nuance is long gone, right? Everything is 100% one way or the other. There's no nuance. You want to support your guy, and maybe it's because it's a Milwaukee, and maybe it's because it's a Buffalo, maybe in a smaller place they want to support their guy. But if you think about it, if you talk to those people and said, what are you standing up for? I would be curious to hear why people said standing ovation for that. Again, as opposed to sit back and say, okay, that wasn't great, you apologize, good, move on, is a much more appropriate response, I think.
This is the Rochester Press Box, which is presented by the Genesee Brewhouse, and we'll talk Buffalo Bills next.